Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier. And in my this particular video, I am going to discuss how we can map the concept of Hogg transformation, whatever we have seen in our previous videos, in discrete domain, because digital images have discrete values of pixels, right, with respect to our x and y coordinate. Okay, now suppose I am having one image like this. Okay, and point to be remembered that whole algorithm cannot be understood in a single video. I'll be discussing it part by part. Just you focus on the algorithm and try to understand that whatever I am discussing in each sub videos. Okay, so here I'll be discussing one major part of that. This particular video is going to give you one good foundation how you can apply Hogg transformation, that is mapping from xy coordinate space to our parametric space of theta rho domain. Okay, and let us try to understand that. So suppose this is our original image, x-axis from left to right, y coordinate, as you know, from top to bottom, because in our image in MATLAB the coordinate point 1, 1 starts from here instead of starting from here like we generally habituated with coordinate system. Okay, so that I have drawn like this, and I have one line here. Now I need to detect this line, or maybe I have some collinear points. I need to find one straight line joining all those collinear points. Okay, whatever that may be, same concept, is same algorithm will work at the back end to solve this type of problems. So first simple thing you should understand that we cannot use concept of MC plane, because for vertical line m goes to infinity, and as a result we cannot get any solution of Hogg transformation using MC space. So we have to use theta rho space, that is normal form of straight line, x cos theta plus y sin theta equal to rho, where theta is basically the angle between the perpendicular line drawn from the origin to that particular line and the positive x-axis, and rho is basically the perpendicular length drawn from the origin to the straight line, right? That space we need to consider, and that should be discrete, right? So two-dimensional discrete space is nothing but can be visualized like simply this kind of matrix, we can say, where theta is in x direction and in y direction the rho perpendicular length, right? So this is small these blocks you can consider as cell. Okay, this particular matrix also called accumulator matrix. Why this is called accumulator, I will be discussing the algorithm and you can understand it very easily. So step one, initially these cells are set to zero. Obvious that when you are starting our algorithm, we don't know any rho theta value, rho and theta value. So as a result, whole matrix, all the cells should be value should be zero. Okay, now you may ask, what is the minimum value of theta, what is the maximum value of theta, what is the minimum value of rho, what is the maximum value of rho? Okay, this question might come in your mind, but no need to consider those for the time being. You just assume some particular theta minimum to theta maximum range we are taking according to our requirement. We have adjusted such that our requirement will fulfill, and same goes for rho. What is the actual range? I will be discussing in my next video. First, try to understand this simple concept. So we have formed one matrix where rho min to rho max and theta min to theta max. We have just made one matrix and all the cells are set to zero. Okay, then what we will do, we will start searching in our original image where the pixel is not a background pixel. Okay, like here you can see here one straight line present of brown color. So while searching, first of all I will hit this particular point, this particular pixel. Okay, now for this particular point, suppose this is xk comma yk in the xy plane. Okay, what we will do, we know the formula of the normal equation, x cos theta plus y sin theta equal to rho. What I will do, I have one particular range from theta min to theta max, right? For all theta value, that is those are distinct integer values, maybe 0 to 180 degree, 0, 1, 2, 3 like that, or maybe minus 90 degree to 90 degree, minus 90 degree, minus 89 degree, minus 88 degree, so on up to 90 degree. Okay, but integer increment, like we have dealt with digital signal processing also, n value, time sample value takes only integer value. Similarly here theta also will take integer, maybe 0 to 180 degree or minus 90 degree to 90 degree. Okay, so for all theta value, what I will do for that particular pixel xk comma yk, understand it very carefully, for that particular pixel xk comma yk, I will put all theta value in the equation x cos alpha plus y sin alpha equal to rho. We don't know the rho, but what I will do, we know xk yk, that I will put in xy value. And what is the theta value? Theta value I will take all possible value in my theta range. Okay, that is minus theta min to theta max. Okay, and then as a result I will be getting one set of value of rho that I will put in our this particular matrix at that corresponding index. Okay, so see, try to understand this particular second point, very very important. For every non-background point xk comma yk, non-background point, that's what, maybe straight line or some point, right? We no need to consider the background. Like here, this is the straight line which is non-background point, so we are starting from this. So this is one non-background pixel xk comma yk in the xy plane. Okay, that is original image plane. We let theta equals each of the allowed subdivision values of theta axis. What this means? As I have told you, theta min to theta max, all possible value in the theta axis. Okay, and solve for corresponding rho value using the equation rho equal to xk cos theta plus yk sin theta. So theta is varying, xk yk is that particular point from our xy plane, and we'll be computing the rho value. Okay, now while computation, these are trigonometric expression, although xk and yk are basically integer, we can say, because image plane coordinate values, pixel coordinates are integer, but theta, cos theta, sin theta may result into some fractional value, and as a result overall expression may go to some fraction. Now rho cannot be fraction, because again this is same concept like discrete values. So discrete values of rho from rho min to rho max is present here. So what we need to do, we need to apply round off. We'll round off to nearest rho, okay, possible in our rho range. Okay, so this is what is written here. The resulting rho, whatever we are getting after applying this particular formula, is then rounded off to the nearest allowed cell value along the rho axis. I hope you can understand it very simply. Now we have got one rho value, many rho values. For all the possible values of theta, we are getting rho values, right? So suppose this is 0 degree, this is 1 degree, 2 degree, 3 degree, 4 degree, 5 degree, 6 degree. Okay, whatever rho values I will be getting, okay, that I will put. Suppose for 0 degree, I am after rounding off, I am getting my rho value equal to maybe 2. Okay, 0, 1, 2. So 2, I will increment this particular part 1 by 1. Okay, initially all values are 0, but as I have got this particular part, some rho value, I'll increment this to 1. Next, for theta equal to 1, suppose I am getting rho value after rounding off at this particular point. What is this rho? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Suppose I am getting rho equal to 5 for theta equal to 2. So theta equal to 2, that means this second column, rho equal to 5 means this one. So I will increment this particular cell value by 1. Okay, so initially all this was 0, so it will be incremented to 1. So each time I'll be doing this, okay, for all the possible range of theta. So that's what it is written here. Third point, if a choice of theta p is basically one integer value in my range of theta, that is theta min to theta max, one distinct value theta p, for that particular theta p, if this particular equation, whatever rho value I am getting after rounding off, if it is generating rho q, then what I will do, I will apply this incrementation a of p comma q equal to a of p comma q plus 1. That is that particular p q index, I will increment that particular part pixel value by 1. Okay, I hope you have understood this, got the idea. Then what this indicates, if we apply all these steps in this particular algorithm, what I will get as a resulting value in this particular domain? You just recall our example of Hogg transformation, whatever I have shown as the example in theoretical way or in MATLAB, okay, in my previous videos. suppose I have taken 5 points, out of which one point is not collinear, and rest of the points are falling on a same straight line, that is, those are collinear. So in the rho theta domain, they will intersect each other at a single point, and one line which is not collinear, that will basically cut all the other lines in some other point. Now, I have told you during the fundamental discussion of Hopf transformation that we need to take that point where maximum number of point, straight lines or sinusoids are intersecting, right? Now, that measurement, how we can get that, suppose that four points which are collinear, if you convert those to our rho theta space, that is, in that case, we will be getting sinusoid. So, four sinusoid will intersect at a single point, and one sinusoid will be there in some other point. Okay. So, that four sinusoid, that four value, how will be getting? Very simple. See, you can intuitively just try to feel this concept. Each time, whenever I am applying this formula, this one, I am incrementing that, right, incrementing that particular index position value. So as a result, whatever value we will be getting in our this particular matrix, okay, whatever value, suppose p value at particular index, suppose this matrix is A, and at particular index I comma j, I am getting p value after applying this first three steps. That means they are p points from xy plane, from this particular plane, p points are intersecting. Okay, I hope you have understood this, that's what it is written. A value of P in A of ij, that is this particular matrix, means P points in xy plane lie on line x cos theta j plus y sin theta j equal to rho I. Okay, so A of ij, so suppose at this particular point, 5 lines are intersecting, we are getting the value 5. That means we will conclude for this particular rho and theta, if we apply this particular formula, whatever straight line I will be getting, in that straight line, 5 points are intersecting. Okay? Now the formula will no longer be this. In this case, xk and yk constant and theta and rho variable. But that time, after applying the first three rules, our rho and theta are fixed and x and y are variable. In this way, we will be getting only straight line, right? So that's what here it is written. A value of P in A of ij means P point in xy plane lie on line x cos theta j plus y sin theta j equal to rho I. Okay. So I hope the fundamental concept, this particular algorithm, is clear to you. So this is all for this video. I will continue my discussion in my next upcoming video. Thank you for watching.